pues cloaca y crema cubana. Voi että mulla on onnellinen. Tää on ihan sattumaa.
Muta video, niin saat voi ottaa tästä videon taustalla.
Vielä aloitetaan.
Hồi đến giờ đó cái đổi á, không cái ăn này như bây giờ thì dậu một con này có con đặc.
En mä usko, että kuitenkaan muutaan puhuttiin, joka voi olla ihan hevosen.
Niin, niin ei sitä voi. Niin.
Mä haluan tommosin
kuvaa, kun ei näitä kuvaa. Mä olen
oikein pakko näköinen. Mä suon kiupaa. Mä
olen oikein pakko näköinen. Mä olen oikein pakko näköinen. Mä olen oikein pakko näköinen. Mä olen oikein pakko näköinen.
Kind of sure. Why are you not in the picture? Get in the picture quickly.
Yeah, that's it. I know it though.
Yeah, but the rest of it is the shit, so that's good.
Exactly.
I'm having.
Two o'clock in the afternoon, we executed Charles. So you see there's, on the top here, there's just behind the tent where the two is, there's a little black mark. This goes 2 p.m. to 30 January 1649. That is a royalist point of view. That was the darkest hour in British history. If you're a Republican, you know, yay, we got rid of the royals finally. But this is 140 years before France chops King Louis' head off. We did it first. And then 10 years became a republic, the Commonwealth of England, Scotland and Ireland. Again, 130 years before the US had a crack at a republic, we gave it a go. The problem with our republic is that we had parliamentarians in charge. The parliamentarians, they were Puritans. Puritans, they were deathly dull. Outlaws, gambling, drinking, they cancelled Christmas in 1644. There's a reason we sent them all the Mayflower to North America. And by 1659, we'd grown a bit weary of it being a Commonwealth republic. So the son, his son, Prince Charles, if he was King Charles II, son says, yes, I would quite like you to be I don't really trust you guys. You've got my brother, which is fair enough, ridiculous. So he wants to expand. And the lifeguards, the guards that were here just before Prince Charles, they're the oldest. They were founded in 1661 to ride back to Charles' coronation in Westminster Abbey. So they all take the blue scrolls. And well, so these are the household division, the cavalry infantry of the royals. So you've got the lifeguards there, the blue scrolls. Guards you see outside the front of my camp, they also come from this period. So the grenadier guards, the oldest foot guards. You can tell which guard it is by removing their bearskin, so they have a white boot left hand side. They were founded to protect the people who were doing a beautiful job, but that's what they're about. The Coldstream Guards, the second oldest, they were founded actually to fight against the Prince Charles in Charles II. So they were super Republicans, they switched to being more guards.
Where you are,
and they're the red people right inside. The Scots Guards, they're the plain grey bearskin. The Irish Guards, they're the Patrick Blue. And the Welsh Guards, they have the blue. The bearskin, it's still bearskin. It's just Canada every year. And the reason we wear them is another thing celebrating the British. Back in Waterloo, no British soldiers wore bearskin. They were called the Imperial Guard. They wore the bearskin. They were the best in muscle men. They wore the bearskin when they're coming out of the cannon fire. No point in posing. So the average soldier would see huge men running towards them. Soldiers like the they often wouldn't be able to find. But Duke of Wellington, and the Coldstream Guards lying down in the tall grass. He was really hard from the cannon fire. He bombarded the Coldstream fire. Coldstream was standing up out of the grass, and so we tell ourselves it's the only time the Imperial Guard ever retreated from the battlefield. And then there's a story about the cowardly us picking up the bears in the cowardly French running away from the battlefield, which is definitely not true. So that's why we still wear the bearskins as commemorating our victory over French. And the gates here, the reason these guards are here, this gate, the front gate is all rolled around on the front gate of Buckingham Palace. So these guys, they'll be on duty until 4 p.m. At 4 p.m., they have a ceremony here, it's called the Punishment Parade. And the Punishment Parade, it stems from 1804, Queen Victoria. She's going back to Buckingham Palace through horse guards here. And she sees all the horse guards on TV. They're all swaying. Yeah, yeah. She's a bit ticked off because it's her personal guard there. So it's a gate guard of the punishment. She says every single day, 4 o'clock, we'll have a good together. We've got some 1994 and all the horse guards are doing it. The late queen, quite liking the ceremony, she decided she was going to be here for another 2094. To see all the horse guards on foot, they all line up. So we go, it's not a red. We can't. We're still coming.
Basket of saddles. No, you can't go.
Come here.
It's 10 minutes ago. Actually, about 14 minutes ago, it's my first video, so.
Det är någonting det där, vi kan gå igenom det.
Just keep it on the